4, the Woolsey fire tore through L.A. and Ventura counties last year, leaving many without a place to call home. But NBC4's Gordon Tokumatsu caught up with one family today who've rebuilt just in time for the holidays.
I'm standing in front of one of 9 homes completely destroyed by the Woolsey fire 1 year ago here in Agoura Hills. Another 4 or so were seriously damaged. But this week, one of the families actually got some good news. Diane Broche remembers the moment, New Year's morning 2019, when she spotted a lone coyote in the parking lot of the hotel where she and her husband, Rami, were staying.
I looked at my husband, I burst into tears. He had no idea what was going on with me.
We've been displaced, she told him, just like that coyote.
It was really devastating.
It was the first time in years that the Broches could not host their annual New Year's party. The Woolsey fire had absolutely gutted their home of 27 years. They were living out of suitcases, wondering when and even if their nightmare might end.
Things were just charred and melted and took, I don't know, maybe 8 months for the 9 months to get the smell out.
Yeah. But that was then, she says, and this is now, slightly more than a year later, and the Broches' home is not only restored after sustaining massive interior damage and a collapsed ceiling.
Show us your favorite part of the kitchen.
I think it's this. It's the island.
It's new and improved, and they've returned home.
To us, that's amazingly fast.
Agoura Hills Mayor Elise Buckley Weber says the city is doing all it can to help others accomplish what the Broches did. It's providing case managers and staff to help them navigate the paperwork and the permits.
It's not so easy to find contractors and plumbers and electricians and everything you need to put a house back together.
But the Broches made it happen, and already they're preparing for Hanukkah in a few days. Then after that, their annual New Year's party.
At least 70 people.
So bigger than ever before.
Ever. Biggest one yet.
The mayor says she hopes other families will be able to recover from their losses just like the Broches did in the months to come. It's just hard to say at this point when that will happen. In Agoura Hills, Gordon Tokumatsu, NBC4 News. Back to you.